beer, unless spirits, beer is very local, right? Meaning every single country produces beer and every single country produces craft beer. Our main focus is still Philippines, right? It's like step by step, we want to be everywhere, we want to be recognized, we want to give people a choice. It's the only thing that we want. Philippines never had a choice in 120 years, just having one beer, which is great. I mean, hey, we're not saying anything bad, it's perfectly great, it's part of the culture, just had one beer, right? And we just want to give a choice. You don't need to look for something Japanese or something from Germany. We have an option for you, right? And that's the only thing that we want. Something really important for craft beer is basically recognition, right? We wanted to prove again on what is our message to the world, which is that Filipinos can do things as good as everyone else, right? So we really love to carry our flag. Again, you see here a white guy, right? But my fiance is Filipina, so I'm almost a Filipino. I've been here for many years, and the rest of the company and his founder, they were really proud Filipino. And we wanted to demonstrate to the world that basically we can do things as good as anyone else, right? You don't need to import something from Germany or from US or from any other place and has to be better. Philippines can do things as good as everyone else, and that's what we want to demonstrate on the beer. To demonstrate this as well, we've been entering our beers to many international awards in all the continents, and we've been winning really a lot of them. So we have more than 30 international awards for the different beers. Well, we've been winning the last 3-4 years, the World Beer Awards for Philippines, gold, silver, and bronze, actually all of them. We won a gold in Australia last year, a gold and 2 bronzes. We won several in Europe as well. We won one of the biggest competitions of the world. It was like a silver for our honey ale in Belgium. And then last year, for our surprise, we won even marketing awards in the biggest beer marketing awards. That was best bottle design of Asia Pacific. There you go, best bottle design of Asia Pacific and best brewery rebrand of the world. And this is a bit controversial because there are craft breweries that didn't want to enter awards at all. For us, to be honest, is a way how to express a bit on the marketing side to tell people that, hey, yeah, it's true, we do good beer, right? So many people, if you show like it's a craft beer from Philippines, they say, nah, sure, I'm gonna drink probably something else. But if you tell, hey, it's a craft beer from Philippines, we've been winning gold awards in all the continents and so on. I mean, it's not that we say that we're good or our cost. It's like everyone says that it's good, right? Competition say that we're good, so you need to trust, and at least what we want is to give us a try. So it's just a part of recognition and making people try, do that first step, right? Trying to convince that, hey, yeah, really, this beer is good. Well, yeah, you have it here. You don't need to import anything from anywhere else. Of craft beer and craft beer culture is to launch seasonals, right? And that's what differentiates commercial versus craft. It means that a commercial brewery or anything commercial in the world takes years to develop a new product, right? They need to do R&D approvals and everything. We have this agility, we have this speed that we can create and we can keep innovating, right? Part of the craft for us is to keep launching seasonals. We want to let people know in the Philippines that what beer can be. Beer can be absolutely everything. And our last one is our Flirty Flamingo Hibiscus Kolsch. The Kolsch is what we would call the lager of the ale. It's a very easy to drink, 5% alcohol in this one. We wanted to create something refreshing. We know that now it's starting summer here in the Philippines. The weather is getting really, really hot, right? And we wanted something refreshing to spend the next 1 to 2 months. Basically, we came with our Hibiscus Kolsch, which basically has local hibiscus, so gumamela and ilang ilang. And you don't really need to get smashed, you know, for drinking beer. Something that is just refreshing, floral. Asians also love tea, right? And it's something that is like a bit of a, almost a crossover. On the quality of beer, basically, one important thing that is not very common on craft breweries is laboratory. So we have a huge laboratory, which is not common. We test absolutely everything that goes out. We're really, really picky on parameters that we know that the beer is always perfect out there. So in terms of quality, we trust that that's the way how to go, and we're gonna keep expanding that part. Basically, we're gonna try to incorporate a lot of different Filipino fruits, Filipino flavors. Basically, because now that we're exporting as well, we want to show the world again, we're carrying the Filipino flag. And we have some fruits that we're gonna be using for the next beers. We have some amazing collaborations that I cannot talk about, but we always want to work with really Filipino brands and just cross cultures, right? So we get together, we throw ideas, and I think that that's the lovely part of being a small company and everyone involved in the culture, right? Everyone has a say on absolutely everything. I mean, that's what we would love, which is the transparency, the trust on each other to be able on what to be able to say on what we can do better and what is not going well, right, to change it. And the trust on each other, and then if you have ideas, we'll love to accept it. At the end of the day, we're open to any, for even if it looks like a crazy, there are no crazy ideas, and that's what I'm gonna say, right? Any idea can be tweaked, and then appears some nice beers, so yeah. People know Philippines for other more commercial things, but we want to put Philippines has, it's just not commercial and low-end stuff, right? Philippines has a huge range of premium products. We have a wonderful country. This country has like one of the best raw materials of the world, which people don't know about that, right? So half of the world is eating the pineapples from here, and no one knows about that. I didn't know about that before, right? So. I think that is one of the best things that could happen for the country. For these small brands carrying the flag, making a dent, like having some impact abroad, is what will put the name out there.